Another generation, another pair of consoles that will undoubtedly have hardware issues. Software updates, breaking, red ring of deaths, blue screens, scratched optical drives, updates, another update for the update, server issues, and on and on and on. There. I basically summarized this whole video. Every 6 or 7 years, we get a new iteration of the latest and greatest tech and video game hardware. And with the release of Xbox's Series X and the PS5, there comes an endless wave of reviews, first impressions, pre-orders, scalpers apparently now, and unavoidable disappointment. It's not uncommon to hear people have a lot of issues with these early versions of new consoles. I mean, it's like tradition that every new generation, someone breaks their PlayStation right out of the box. Or that their Xbox starts smoking. Not even a week old, and this thing is already cooler than I ever was as a teenager. That whole thing, that whole smoke issue, was fake, so relax. Even in this generation, there's already instances of issues with the Xbox Series X and the PS5, with some people expressing that their systems have crashed and sometimes overheated. Other users have been running into the issues of their disk drives not actually working, like not even accepting the disks. You gotta love physical.
Please know that this was a joke and said in a sarcastic manner. I am not liable for any offense this may have caused to physical gaming enthusiasts. I am part of this community. Please don't revoke my membership. Side effects may include nausea, an irreparable superiority complex, diarrhea, loss of shelf space, and in rare occasions, death.
Alright, now that I got that out of the way. Issues with overheating from this new generation have been brought up and theorized to be caused by the unusual design these new consoles have. And can I just say thank you? Thank you, Sony and Microsoft, for daring to redesign your consoles. Thank you for stepping out of your comfort zone and destroying expectations with this generation's console designs. Don't get me wrong, they're still ugly as hell, but at least it's not a black box anymore. Kinda. Actually, I take that back. The issues with buying newly released consoles is a tradition at this point. Back in the day, you know, when Steam wasn't a thing, there were loads of issues with the first few batches of consoles. Sony's debut into the console world was such a case. The PS1, a console lauded by many to be their childhood, summarized, with games such as Crash Bandicoot, Final Fantasy VII, and Tekken, all propelled this little great box to success. However, upon release, this console actually had a myriad of hardware issues. One common issue with the first batch of PS1 sold to the public were due to poorly placed vents, which caused the console to overheat, resulting in gamers experiencing skipping video frames and sometimes even ticking noises coming from the console. Imagine what it was like explaining to your parents, which probably already hate the thought of a console, that it was making ticking noises. They probably thought it was a bomb. It probably was big video game media placing bombs inside your homes. Another issue that plagued the PS1 was with the laser unit that read the game discs. Given that the first batch of PlayStations were mostly made of plastic, over time some movable parts would wear out due to friction. One part would wear out so much that the actual laser would be unable to properly read the data on the discs. The most common fix to this would be to turn the PlayStation upside down. Yes, I know that this is a great analogy for what 2020 has been. Later on, we would have this nifty thing that came into play. I think they call them the internet and servers. I don't know, they might be big in the game industry going forward. The Wii, released on November 19th of 2006 to huge commercial success, it became Nintendo's best-selling home console of all time, surpassing their own NES with over 101 million units sold worldwide. This little thing became to be a world record setter. However, it was also met with launch hardware issues. I'm starting to think that disc-based consoles don't fare too well with launches. The Wii's first system software update caused a few launch units to turn completely unusable. The update was meant to be downloaded from the Wii's app Wii Connect 24, which is ironic because this seems like a huge oversight from Nintendo. Nintendo basically bricked their own consoles. Nintendo then began offering replacement consoles for gamers who ran into this issue. Man, can you imagine that? Nintendo having software and hardware oversight issues and then doing the bare minimum to fix them? You know, a lot of things can change in like a decade, but the older I get, the more things stay the same. Now, to stick to disc-based consoles whose first batch of units absolutely sucked, y'all remember when the Xbox 360 was the console to have? With its sleek design, its high-definition graphics, its amazing online services, and without a doubt, its amazing exclusives, yeah, it's not crazy to see why the Xbox 360 was the console to have. But the first batch of these things f***ing sucked. Back in the classic years of Modern Warfare lobbies where you got called racial slurs, the original model of the Xbox 360 were actually defective. After a while, these systems would actually fail and generate a general hardware failure, but everybody just called it the Red Ring of Death because, let's be honest, Microsoft isn't the best at naming shit. The issues stemming from this Red Ring of Death were so prominent that Microsoft has actually made it their goal to reduce the number, size, and placement of hardware components inside their more recent units. They changed their whole design practices because of the Red Ring of Death. Let's see how the Xbox Series X fares with this, because it's already kind of built like a sausage with everything crammed inside this phallic piece. Look, console redesigns are inevitable. It's the only reason why I'm holding off from buying the next gen consoles. You can't expect to get everything right the first time. I mean, that's why people do prenups. I really hope my girlfriend isn't seeing this video. What I'm particularly waiting for is for bundles that are worth it, either a redesign if these first batches actually prove to be faulty, for scalpers to f***ing go back to their sneaker scamming business, or if they ever release a slimmer version of the PS5 because, my God, that boy is big. Holy shit, man. That thing is the size of my torso. I don't have the desk space. I don't have an entertainment system. Bro, I'm gonna have to just get a piece of furniture to just hold my PC and the PS4 at this point. Regardless, I don't want y'all to think that I am hating on next gen. That's far from it. That's far from what I'm trying to say. I'm actually extremely excited for this new gen. It's opening up the opportunity for great games to be created. With the upgrade in accessibility and technology, developers now have more liberty to create truly astonishingly looking games. And regardless of what people say, this competition, this going back and forth between Xbox and PlayStation is only good for us, for the player. Competition creates amazing results. I'm looking at you, Nintendo. PlayStation better get on the handheld market, bro. Nintendo really needs some competition at this point. Let's just hope that the hardware for these next-gen consoles are future-proof and that it doesn't overheat and or melt components. Because, man, I can't afford it. But you let me know what you think. Do you have a PS5, an Xbox Series X already? Or are you holding out for the next batch consoles to come out after, I mean, I like to call it inevitable issues arise, but I honestly feel that Microsoft and Sony did their homework and the issues have been minimal to this point. If anything, the only issues have been that the Xbox has no games. That's it. Folks, I've been True Fernie. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe. The links to my socials are down below. Please make sure to follow me on Twitch, where I stream Mondays, Wednesdays, sometimes Fridays, and definitely Sundays. I am an affiliate over there, so all of your support down there is greatly appreciated. By the way, I have some exciting news coming. There is something in the works that I'm really excited to bring to the channel, and hopefully it's successful. I know it will be. But with that, please take care of each other, but most importantly, take care of yourself. And don't be dipping your PS5s in water. Just why, man? Like, God, y'all piss me off so much. Peace.